God only. And immediately, when Jesus perceived in his spirit that they so reasoned within themselves, he said unto them, why reason ye these things in your heart? Verse 9. Whether is easier, which is easier, to say to the sick man, paralyzed man, thy sins be forgiven thee, or to say, arise, take up thy bed and walk? Let's pause. Which one is easier to say? He's asking, which is easier for me to say, not do? Okay? Which one's easier for me to say? Your sins be forgiven, or arise, take up your bed and walk? What do you think? And why? Why do you, which one's easier to, for me to say to a paralyzed man, your sins be forgiven, or arise, take up your bed and walk? Which one's easier for me to say?
Sins.
You know why?
Can't see it.
If I say, arise, take up your bed and walk, well, it's about to be proven. We're going to see if this is going to happen for real. If I say, oh, when you go home, peace will be in the air. It's kind of like, hey, man. We can't argue that. But if you say, arise, take up your bed and walk, it's like, well, paralyzed man, you're going to have to get up. So he said what's easier to the guy. Luke chapter 5, we're going to start reading from verse 15. Yes, 15. I want to just give a little prelude. In verses 12 to, let's say, 12 to 14, Jesus Christ healed a leper, a man that had leprosy. He healed him, okay? And then you see in the beginning of verse 14, it says, and he charged him, he told him, he commanded him, don't tell any man, don't tell anybody, but go show thyself to the priest, go to the pastor, and give an offering. Show them your testimony, let them know what the Lord has done. But guess what? Verse 15. But so much the more went their fame of Jesus. Jesus Christ got even more popular. He told him not to tell anybody. But for some reason, after he left, he got more popular. Must have told somebody. And great multitudes came together to hear and to be healed by him of their infirmities. I like this verse, verse 16. And he withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed. And now some of your versions may be a little more detailed. He withdrew often, right? Am I right? Some. Okay, good. Some versions say oftentimes or frequently or occasionally. Why? Let's say you sing, you dance, preach, speak, you're an artist. You act, take pictures, whatever it may be. And now you go into a circle. You go into a circle where the people around you are clearly not as skilled as you are. Maybe you're the best photographer in that circle. You know you are, and they know you are too. You're the best singer in that circle. They know you are, and you know it too. You're the best dancer. They know you are, and you know you are too. You're the smartest person in that circle. You're the most wise. You're the wisest. Okay? So now they come to you for all these things. Can you show us this move? Can you take this picture? Teach us this. Sing this. How do we hit this note? Preach to me. You know? So now you tell them. But now guess what? After you leave, you go into another circle. A circle of 10. Top 10 around the world. Top 10 dancers. Top 10 singers. Top 10 preachers. Top 10 actors, top 10 photographers. Brother, sister, you're not going to have that same study. You're not going to have that same feeling like, oh, I know I'm the best here, because you're not. And you know what it's going to do to you? Humble. The way you stay humble is always going back to someone who's far better than you. Christ often prayed. He often went away. How do you stay humble? Often went away to pray. Go into the presence of someone greater than you. You'll be humble. You think you look kind of fine? You're the best girl in Brother Grant. I'm fine this year. And you go into another hot model circle. You look like some doo-doo. You
look like some straight doo-doo. They have no makeup on, they look finer than all of them. You're not gonna be like, that's gonna quickly go to a little shrimp mode, a little turtle mode. You're gonna grow a shell if you ain't got one, you're gonna grow a shell. You're gonna hide. You know why? Because you're in the presence of people better than you. You wanna stay humble, sister? You wanna stay humble, brother? You always go back to someone who's greater than you. And when you're in that person's presence, you can't flex. You know what? You can just lay down, bend down, kneel down. You gotta go down, lower yourself, okay? He often did this. Why was Christ so humble? He was always in the presence of God. And you know he's not better than him, so you gotta stay low. Verse 23. Whether it's easy to say thy sins be forgiven, or to say rise up and walk. But that ye may know the Son of Man hath power upon the earth to forgive sins, he said to the sick of palsy, I say unto thee, arise, take up thy couch, take up thy bed or thy couch, and go into thine house. And immediately, verse 25, and immediately he rose up, went before them, and took that wherein he lay, and departed to his own house, glorifying God. Verse 24. Christ commanded him to take up his bed. Why? Because, oh, we don't have enough room in here. We need that bed out of here. No, no, no. Don't ever forget where you used to be. Don't ever forget who you used to be. Just think back 2 years. Think back three. Think back 10. Who were you back then? Don't forget. You know, every time that man sees that bed, he can't look at someone else and say, haha, you're paralyzed. No, that's not happening. Because he knows. As a matter of fact, if he did do that, he's beyond cursed. Anybody that maybe they were unattractive, okay? Back in the day, they were just ugly. You know, not ugly. They were just unattractive. Okay, people, it's just, you know, it's obvious, like, they're just not, you know, not, it's just not. But now, you know, God had mercy. They cried too much, you know. When they start to grow, you know, features started being defined, you know, hair start changing, you know, lips start forming, and now they're like, kind of attractive. If that he, you heard it wrong. If that he, that's me too, if that he or she ever looks at someone that may not be what they call this aesthetically pleasing, attractive, and then like insults them, oh, beyond cursed, beyond. So how dare you? You know, Proverbs 24, someone can go there. I mean, we don't have to alter that. Proverbs 24, verse 17. Proverbs 24, verse 17. Whoever gets it, please read slow and slow and out loud.
Don't rejoice when your enemies fall.
Don't rejoice when someone else falls.
Don't be happy when they stumble.
Don't even be happy when they stumble. You know, falling and stumbling are different. You know, someone falls flat, bow, it's like, oh. You know, we have a testimony. Don't laugh. You know our enemy, by the way. Don't laugh when your enemy falls. You know, it's like, bam, someone's like, oh. Now they're stumbling. You know, don't laugh at either. Don't rejoice when they fall. And don't laugh when it's time to go on. Why? Let's hear why.
Verse 18. Mm-hmm. For the Lord will be displeased with you, and will turn his anger away from them.
He'll be displeased, and he'll stop. It's like you laughing at the enemy. First of all, if it's an enemy of you, it's probably an enemy of God. If you're a child of God, it's kind of like that person's against you, okay? It's probably an enemy of God. But he said, don't even laugh at them. When they fall or stumble, don't laugh, don't snicker, don't giggle, don't chuckle. None of that. That's right, all of it. Don't do any of that. Why? Because it displeases the Lord. Because you once were an enemy of God too. You used to be an enemy before you came to Christ. That's what you used to be. Don't laugh at anybody. Don't make fun of anybody. Don't look down on anybody. Because you used to be there. He said, take up your bed and walk. Don't forget where you used to be. Don't forget who you used to be. Don't look down anybody, no matter who they are.
Even if they're an enemy of God, don't laugh at them. Because it displeases the Lord. He didn't like that. He'll stop the hurt. He'll pick them up from the fall if he sees you laughing at them. Even if they deserve to fall, he'll pick them up. Because you're laughing, you're rejoicing.